Hey y'all, I'm Lisa Respers France, and this is Pop Off. I'm here to help you feel a little less guilty about your guilty pleasures. I'll let you know what people are talking about and what they should be talking about so you can join in the conversation. Think of it as a boss brunch where the tea is as hot as the mimosas are bubbly. I'm pretty bubbly too, so let's pop off. This week, we're diving into our obsession with the royals, chatting with the stars of the new film Everybody's Talking About Jamie, and breaking down a beloved Jay-Z meme. My best friend Audrey Irvine is here with me, so let's get into it. First, let's talk about my latest obsession, the royal family. That's because the film Spencer is coming out in a couple months. Kristen Stewart stars in Spencer. It's basically an imagining of the dark times in Princess Diana and Prince Charles's marriage. I'm into it.
She does look like her.
Okay, can we talk about that?
Go ahead.
Let's talk about the fact that when I first heard that she was gonna be cast in this film, I was like, that's the Twilight girl.
What's a wolf thing?
I'm sorry, Kristen Stewart has a long resume. She's done a lot. She's always gonna be the Twilight girl to me. I was like, how is she gonna pull that off?
And no one believed that she could
pull it off. Believed it. Yep. But then I saw the photos and I was like, she nails Princess Diana.
The hair.
All of that. The tragedy, like her face just looks like, it's tragic, it's painful.
Oh, the pain, the hunched pain. Over yes. Picture in the long, gorgeous dress. Her back looked fabulous.
Her back looked amazing. That was a Peloton back. That was a Peloton back.
And if you think otherwise, you can meet me outside, okay?
That was a Peloton back, if ever I saw a Peloton back.
If we could work for that.
Absolutely. Here's a woman who seemed like she had it all. She's married to the future king of England. She has these two adorable little boys. So then to learn what tragedy was going on behind the scenes, how sad she was, how unhappy she was. She also is the epitome of what is really wrong with celebrity. I mean, every time I think about her life, you have to also think about her tragic death and how she was pursued by the paparazzi. Now, because of the death of Princess Diana, they became kind of the bad guys. Whereas before, people thought, well, you know, they're just making a living. They're just pursuing the subjects. When you have someone die in a tragic auto accident because they're being pursued by photographers because they can make so much money off of getting those pictures, and then after the fact, they didn't even help her while she was in the car, it did not cast the paparazzi in a great light at all.
And then it really changed the relationship that her sons had with the media, right?
Yes.
You could see that as they grew up around that and recognized and knew what had happened to their mother, their relationship with the media totally changed at that point.
Team Harry or Team William?
Come on now.
Team Harry.
Team Harry, when he was in Jamaica dancing with Usain Bolt.
Hello.
It's over.
We love a ginger.
Mental, that one, I'm telling you.
Those are the real royals, but we love us some fake royals as well. The Crown, everything. Love that show, obsessed with that show. And next year we get season 5 of The Crown. Are you into the royals at all?
Not as much as you. Do you think you're part of the family?
It's the wealth for me. I feel like I should be famous and rich and royal.
Can you have the wealth, the fashion without the work?
It doesn't feel like work to me.
Do they wear corsets? Ooh.
I wouldn't be mad at a corset.
Did you have to look down when you said that?
Yeah.
You're high enough.
Let's keep in mind, this is all dramatization. We want to believe that this is what really happened. But, you know, Netflix does a great job when it comes to these types of shows. It was lush, it was messy. It was all the reasons why I watch and enjoy these shows.
How long is this gonna go on? I feel like it's gonna be like Law & Order 5, and it's gonna be like The Crown 20. I mean, how long are they gonna take this going?
It's been 84 years.
I want it to keep going on and on. We at least have to see Meghan Markle get treated like dirt.
But we've seen that live.
I need the Netflix version. And you know who else has a British accent?
Who?
The stars of Everyone's Talking About Jamie. The film stars Max Harwood as a teenager who longs to be a drag performer. The cool thing about Max is that this was his first role ever in anything. Like, I don't even think he had even appeared on like a surveillance camera in a store. This is the first time this man was on camera and he completely nails it as Jamie. He's just adorable.
The film makes very important points about the history of the LGBTQ community. What are you hoping that people take away from the film regarding that?
Yeah, I think it's just important for my generation and Lauren's generation to remember the history and to remember where we've come from. You know, there's still so many battles we have to fight. And we've made some fantastic shifts since the 80s, and that's because of the shoulders that we sit on as queer people, and it's important to remember that, and you know that our voices are only as strong as they are now because of the people before us.
I'd like people to take away joy. That's as simple as that, really. Because this is, you know, a story about a young queer kid, but it could feel very niche. It's a young queer kid from the north of England, from a working class community, from the projects, a world that I knew really well, you know. But really, I think it represents anybody wanting to take their place in the world and feeling that they can do that in a safe place.
Ladies and gentlemen,
legit.
Would you give a warm welcome for the soon to be legendary
Jamie New?
Me. Sorry, miss. Just daydreaming.
I just like when people bust out in song. Audrey, don't bust out in song.
Holding it together.
Now it's time to pop back. Let's keep it European, y'all. It's the 25th anniversary of one of my favorite films, Stanley Tucci's Big Night.
Let's eat. Yeah!
You know I love a good food movie.
Yes, you do.
I do, and Big Night, all that Italian food, all that pasta, it was as abundant as I am.
Is there wine?
There's, of course there's wine, it's Italian.
I mean, I just wanted to check.
Big Night is about two immigrant brothers from Italy. They open their dream restaurant, and we get to see their lives inside the restaurant, and we get to see Stanley Tucci and his brother make the most glorious meal. I'm getting so hungry just thinking about it. Stanley Tucci, he's a family member.
Yes.
He's part of the CNN family. He's got this great series called Searching for Italy.
It just melts in your mouth.
Again, Italian food. Do you see where I'm going here, people? There's a theme. Why do we not live in Italy?
Because we don't speak Italian.
Oh, there's that.
Okay.
Stanley Tucci has a viral video where he's making a Negroni.
Love that.
Oh, Stanley Tucci, I think I'm in love with you.
That's good.
Food movies are kind of like porn. I mean, we watch them like that.
Really succulent and delicious.
When I call my mom and she's watching like the Food Network or the Cooking Channel, she'll be like, oh yeah.
It's very intimate.
It is very intimate and it's very passionate.
This one's good.
Do you cook when you watch these shows?
If
you watch a food movie, do you feel like you need to remake what you just watched?
My chefs are Uber, Postmates, and Grubhub.
Wow, and you actually said that out loud.
I did.
Okay.
Welcome to our favorite segment, What's It All Meme? This week, it's Jay-Z with a glass of wine on the couch. Here's the backstory for this. There is allegedly, we have to say that because of our legal folks, allegedly a beef between Kanye and Drake. Jay-Z did music with both Kanye and Drake.
You are now watching the throne. Don't let me get in my zone.
So people were actually looking for Kanye to finally release his Donda album. We got it, y'all. We finally got a Donda album.
Sunday at 8 a.m.
Right, around about the time that Drake released his album, because allegedly this is how very competitive the two of them are. And I feel like you shouldn't have to pick. Why can't we have both Kanye and Drake? A little yay, a little Drake. Drake, yeah, tried to make it yay and Drake.
No,
I can't ship them.
No, yay.
Well, first of all, full disclosure, we're not picking sides when it comes to Kanye or Drake. We love us some yay, and there may be footage of me and Audrey dancing to a Drake song in a castle in Ireland. That happened.
Possibly.
Yeah, I feel like this whole beef between Kanye and Drake is just, it could be settled with a pillow fight. Because, I mean, we don't really have beefs anymore in hip hop. We don't allow them. So just get together, do a pillow fight. You both are great. You both are amazing. You both are selling a lot of records. There's room for Kanye and Drake. I feel like MTV would be all over that. Celebrity pillow fights. I want my piece of the cut if that happens, MTV.
Pick your lane, girl. This is not it.
Straight from Watch the Throne to Watch the Chair. That's what you all should be checking out. I'm always looking for great content, and I convinced Audrey to watch The Chair, which is on Netflix. This show is really triggering for me because I used to work at a university, and Sandra Oh's character is dealing with issues that come about when you're a woman of color in certain spaces. Like, you can never forget that you're a woman of color in certain spaces. It's the little microaggressions and things like that that are portrayed so wonderfully well on this show.
There she is.
Our first lady chair.
Woman, I'm not gonna sugarcoat this.
It's incredible writing, great acting, but it really got to me because you see these women dealing in this university setting with people who don't really particularly feel like they're up to the standards of what is needed to work at a college like this.
I also love that they tackled ageism,
yes,
which I think is something that doesn't really get tackled a lot in cinema.
This show talked about ageism, sexism, racism. It was all of the isms. People still want to say that talking about racism is racist. I hear this all the time. This is not true. It could not be further from the fact. But it's such an ugly thing. No one wants to be called racist. No one wants to be accused of acting in a racist manner.
What I like is that we transitioned from the extremes of racism, right? Because a lot of times, a lot of movies just show the extremes of it. So then, of course, someone's like, oh, well, I don't do that. Right. I don't hang up, you know, I don't burn a cross,
right,
and I don't wear this. So, of course, I'm not racist. But they show sort of in a very real atmosphere of the little microaggressions, the little opportunities where you may not even be aware what you're
right.
doing is racist activity. And
exactly.
so that's what I think I appreciated the most, was the subtleties in showing how real this felt.
And Sandra Oh is just an incredible actress. Give her all of the awards.
All the praise.
All the praise, because this is a role that I think in anyone else's hands could have not felt as deeply genuine and not really moved us, and I'm speaking for us because I know you were moved, you better have been moved. And they were only half an hour long episodes, so it was so easy to binge. And
Absolutely.
I know you all are looking for stuff to binge. Stop acting like we're out of content. We have not been in a pandemic that long. There's still plenty of stuff to watch streaming. Thanks so much for joining us, and please do hit that subscribe button so you can pop in on new episodes. Be sure to also subscribe to my weekly newsletter, Pop Life Chronicles, on CNN Digital. See you guys next week.